Hey, what up, everybody? Thank you for joining me for this season of Phil John's VIP. Man, I really didn't know what was going to happen when I started this, but I'm so glad that my industry friends and colleagues decided to come and engage and have conversation with me. I want to give a shout out to the brothers of the Gentleman's Corner. Thank you for all your support, and hopefully one day we can have a network where my show could really segue into your show like it's supposed to be. It's just not all about me, but it's about what I can extend out into the world and how I want to show up into the world. So for that, I want to thank Jeanette Branch, Yolanda Ross, Tony Vitale, Phil Galinsky, my brother Tuffy Quistel, the beautiful Andrea Lewis, the wonderful and magnificent Arlene Lott, my boy Michael Kennedy, Guru Enlightenment, you're a special being. And shout outs to my girl Pernell Walker for her Emmy consideration for City on the Hill on Showtime. I'm super proud of you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All of you, thank you for just engaging me. And hopefully in the fall, we will come back with more people, more interviews, more insight on the industry and our lives. And my prayers to you is that I want you to continue to be in love, continue to be in light, and most of all, be in peace. God bless. See you in the fall.
Well, let you guys know, I'm about to do a live with my guy, Phil John, and come join us because it's going to be actors talking about career and just creative stuff. Cool.
Hey!
What's up, brother? What's going on? First of all, let me just say, I'm busting your cherry. I'm the first one to be on your show. And listen. I'm really, really proud of you for doing this. So, you know.
Yolanda Ross!
You got open questions?
Huh?
You got open questions?
Yeah, I have my 5 open questions. My Super Soul Sunday questions that I'm asking everybody. First of all, thank you for taking the time to join me tonight.
No, dude, of course, love you.
I appreciate it, man, I really do. I thank you for everything.
I'm in the wrong van. So I shoot up my hand, I'm like, I gotta get out of here, I'm sorry guys, I'm in the wrong van, I'm not an extra, I actually got a part. They're like, dick, what a dick! And I'm crawling over people, get over the van, get out of the van, like, you're such a dick! Where did I leave off?
They were calling you a dick in the other vein.
Yeah.
There she is.
I don't know why I do that all the time. And then there's those times when I'm, you know, not doing anything and I see others succeeding. And I ask myself, is there something you could have done more to succeed that you didn't do?
Yay, Mike. Seriously, this is rated PG. And there you go. I just said,
PG. Bruh.
Until she called me one day and said, hey, you know the campaign that we're working on for the new product launch? I said, yeah, I've been working on it for the last, you know, couple of weeks. And she goes, well, I want you to do the voiceover for it. And I was like, so she's like, well, come into the studio on you know, over the weekend. This was in New York. You know, we'll give you the 2 scripts and I'll pay you on the spot and you leave. And I said, okay. And I did the spots. They were very happy. I got paid, and I was like, this is fun.
Yep!
Hello!
What do you do?
How are you? I'm good. You can hear me all right? Everything's good?
Everything's good.
I did Down in the Delta, which is a film that was directed by Maya Angelou. But I was a kid. I was like 11, 12 years old. So I think it was only after that I was like, oh, shit. Oh, okay. This is kind of a big deal. And my grandmother had this huge reaction to it and like stuff like that. So that was maybe my first time recognizing that you could get big opportunities more than anything. That big opportunities can kind of just fall into your lap, I guess you could say. And in this business particularly.
Ah, there you go. It worked.
That was really kind, thank you. I'm currently doing graphics on a movie for Netflix. It's a lovely little story. It's called 13 the Musical. And it's a play show. So that's quite nice. It's a coming of age story about a little kid from New York whose parents split up and he gets dragged out to Indiana during the divorce. And now he's coming up to his bar mitzvah and he doesn't have any friends and he's moved to this new little town. So it's a really sweet coming of age.
Ah!
So good to see you. I'm blessed to be here. Thank you, brother, so much.
Coming into the business, a lot of what I wanted to do early on was to learn just the business of how it all comes together. Mm-hmm. And one name was synonymous. It was Tuffy. And that's the question God, was, do you know Tuffy? I mean, as far back as the Video Music Box days, but I just I remember it was always
there. Are you a Virgo?
You always, no, I'm a Leo. I know. It's okay. Thank you so much, Pernell, for taking the time out to come and just kind of like kick with me forward.
That's it?
Well, you know, wait, hold up. Listen, you know, I always tell people I want to honor your time.
I want to keep doing great work. I am, right now, I'm just like submitting myself a stuff. And being open to what City on a Hill may bring. You know, that's it. I'm just going to be open.
You have the power to make things happen, just like you did when you said to yourself, I want to do this.
Yeah.
Okay? You were the universe. Yeah. You are the power. You made it happen. We are all universe. And why? Because if we become from something that is powerful, and we come from another universe, then you are the universe.
Yeah.
You understand? If you did this show, you did it because you chose to do it. It had nothing to do with the universe. It really didn't. You made it happen. You manifest it. You manifest it. That's how powerful you are, Phil.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you for allowing yourself to follow that journey that brought you here today to speak to me. So I bow to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I love you.
Love you too.